I wish I could rewind and go back in time and show this to my younger self and tell her that it's gonna be okay. Eventually, you're gonna be a Barbie. 1+ size princess.
I feel like a cupcake.
I feel like a glitter bomb.
I personally do feel like Tyra Banks right now. What's that movie? Life Size, yeah.
I feel like I'm about to have the best quinceañera and invite Barbie and Ken and Skipper.
I think Barbie, by having a size inclusive collection, is saying that any woman can be Barbie. It's who's inside and not so much that plastic figure.
It's about damn time. We here, we been here.
I think Barbie is saying, I see you. Like, hey ladies everywhere, it's important that you see yourself in me.
I think it's healthy for young women to understand that there are plenty of different body shapes.
Back when I had my prom, I couldn't find a dress in my size. This kind of makes me happy, like, to be able to think about what it would have been like if I would have had a dress like this to wear to my prom.
Is this the whole thing, that like you can dress exactly like your Barbie? Because I might have to take this with me.
Oh my God, it's my sister.
She doesn't even have a crown. Where's your crown?
Girl, we twins? No shoes, girl. You can't go out of the house without a fancy heel on.
I don't know, I'm like emotional. I'm kind of the opposite of Barbie. I have dark hair, tattoos, and plus size.
It's surreal, because like when I was younger, I couldn't fit into the my size Barbie doll dresses. Like, you know how like they had the Barbies that came with the dress for you to wear? I could never fit those, because I've always been like a chubby kid.
I never thought I would see this in my lifetime. Barbie and I have the same dress. How did that happen?
Wow.
She doesn't have to deal with the sequins though.
I went to prom and I had a dress that was all sequins on the top, and my underarms were like raw by the end of the night. I was like, this was a huge mistake.
I thought I was gonna have like some issue right here because of the sequins, but it feels really comfortable.
I do feel like I could start a fire with my armpits right now. That's just something that you're gonna have to deal with as a choice. Maybe, you know, do some tricks, extra deodorant or something.
And it cuts you right in a decent part where you can eat a big sandwich and you'd be okay.
I actually go for dresses nowadays that are like past the knee.
I do think it's well made. This dress has the potential to survive a night of drinking and dancing.
What I think of when I think of Barbie, really my childhood.
It was like what I would imagine being an adult when I was younger.
I think a boss lady. I would even say nowadays maybe feminist icon. Just a touch.
Growing up with a Barbie and knowing that she was able to do anything, it was nice to know that I could do anything if I really put my mind to it.
I was an only child, so Barbie was my friend, Ken was my friend.
I grew up with a lesbian mother, and my mother never dressed up and never was girly. Barbie was the feminine role model for me because my mom didn't teach me how to dress up. And so when I saw Barbie dressing up, I'm like, okay, I want to dress up like that.
I had an imaginary friend when I was younger, and she was tall, blonde, white girl, like very skinny, just exactly that.
Barbie looks nothing like me.
I don't know if I really compared myself to Barbie. I think I just liked playing with dolls.
OG Barbie, I would say, proportionately is not necessarily accurate to women, but she's very pretty, has beautiful hair and little hands and little feet.
I think I was always compared to Barbie. I'm tall, I'm white, I have blonde hair and blue eyes, but I'm about 100 pounds too heavy. Always jealous of Barbie.
I recall as a child looking at her body going, is this what I'm going to be looking like? And looking at my mother and thinking, where do I fit in this?
There were undertones that I didn't even realize I was picking up on. For instance, the classic waistline. I think even now, as an adult, I'm affected with how, you know, society was looking at bodies of women at the time.
When Cinderella came out with Brandy, she had her own Barbie, and that was my favorite Barbie because she had the braids.
I started straightening my hair really young. I wanted my hair to be like Barbie. I even went to the extent of like bleaching my hair.
When I was a kid, I would have just wanted a Barbie with curly hair. Like, that would have been like the thing that I could have resonated with.
I know my mom's side of my family, and they're all white, and I'm the one that sticks out. If I had a Barbie that looked more like me, I would have been more confident about my curly hair and my darker skin tone than my family members a lot sooner.
When I was little, I used to put a little tissue around my Barbie. I taped tissue on my Barbie, like, and then put the dresses over so that the Barbie could look more like me. And so I wanted the Barbie to have like a little belly like I did when I was little. My friends used to make fun of me, like, what's wrong with your Barbie? I'm like, she's more realistic now. She looks like me.
I had this like Barbie trunk, and it had like these pictures pictures of Barbie on it. Like, I don't look like that. That doesn't look like me. Like, I just went like down the line of like all the different Barbies on that trunk. And then I kind of just like internalized that over the years. You know, it's not Barbie's fault per se. You're seeing these images that are out there and you don't look like them. So then you kind of like have like an inadequacy issue.
It definitely could have shaped the way I looked at the world, as in, there is no other look than this.
It was very important to me to have a black Barbie because I was a black kid with a black mom and a black dad, kind of just relating to my actual life. Having an array of Barbies as a kid, as opposed to only ones that look like me, allowed me to have an understanding that the world outside was made up of, you know, this melting pot of people.
I think I got used to not seeing dolls that look like me. I just thought, oh, I'm the biggest one in the room. You know, it is what it is. But then as I got older and I realized that, you know, I am worthy of seeing someone that looks like me. And so when the plus size Barbies launched, I was so excited.
Barbie has definitely changed a lot. Now they have Barbies of all different sizes and all different backgrounds.
Kids now could have a Barbie that's, you know, a little thicker, a little shorter, taller, thinner, freckles, different color hair.
In the eighth grade, I was diagnosed with vitiligo, and they actually came out recently with a vitiligo doll. So I think having that doll and having that representation back then definitely would have helped me out.
I went to go buy the curvy Barbie and I couldn't find it anywhere on shelves. It took me 2 weeks to buy it online.
Now she's, you know, like Congresswoman, and like she's a gymnast, and she's all these amazing things, and it's healthy to see. Like, we need to see that, I think.
Barbie is just a doll. That's what she looks like to me. She doesn't look like me. Will I think that she'll ever look like me? No. But I am happy that there is a curvy Barbie, a plus size Barbie, and also Barbies that come like in different roles, like a scientist, a pilot. Like, that I think is rad, and I love it.
To see this dress on a bunch of different women is very empowering.
Having the opportunity to wear a Barbie dress in any size could be almost magical.
Barbie, you rock. Keep rocking. Girl power. That's what the hat says, right?
She's working hard at making everyone feel like the badass bitch that she is. Badass bitch. Sorry, Barbie.
I don't want to be Lego Barbie. I am a Barbie.